Hey friends, welcome back to your very own channel Social Sciences Junction. In this video, we have tried to compile a list of some essential books which you can read for the preparation of the prelims part of the examination of Assam Public Service Commission. We have tried to cover the general studies syllabus as provided by the APSC in its website. This is the first part of the lecture and it covers some four or five of the topics as mentioned in the syllabus. And in subsequent lectures, we will come up with the remaining topics of the syllabus as mentioned by APSC. Please watch this video till the end and do like and share, like this video and share it with your friends who you think will be benefited by this video. At this time, we would also like to request you to kindly subscribe to our channel if you haven't done it already. Dear friends, it doesn't take much effort to go down and click on that red button called subscribe. But believe me, this very simple gesture of yours motivates us and inspires us to put in even more hard work each day. So please subscribe to this channel if you haven't done it already. Dear friends, at the outset, we must mention that the list which we are providing here is not a universal list. To say that, there surely are other books and other resources which you will come across mentioned by your friends, your teachers in the coaching institutes, you know, by following the interviews of the toppers. They will mention different books at different times. By mentioning the list of some particular books in this video, we do not intend to suggest or propose that all the other books mentioned by your teachers, by your friends, by your colleagues are useless or irrelevant. They might as well be very much relevant for the preparation of APSC prelims, but the book list which we are trying to provide here is, we believe, a very comprehensive list of books, and covering all these books thoroughly will be pretty much sufficient for you to prepare for the prelims level of the examination. You do not need to read like 200 books for political science, 100 books for history, 50 books for geography, and so on and so forth. What you need to do is you need to have a very good hold about the very basic books on the very, you need to have a very good hold on the very basic books which will provide you the very basic information. So we have tried to compile such a list for you. So let's see in the video. Let's look into some of the very important and preliminary points for the preparation of the prelims level of the APSC examination before going in details about the list of books which you need to read for particular topics. So first, we have already mentioned in our previous videos, reading newspapers. Yes, dear friends, reading newspapers regularly and thoroughly is very, very essential, because without doing this, it doesn't matter much how many NCRTs, how many, you know, guidebooks you read or you cover. Reading newspapers is essential and you cannot deny the importance of it, irrespective of whatever other material or whatever other books you read. Do make notes, do revise them adequately and in the adequate period of within adequate period of gap. Do not delay your revisions too much, because after a particular point of time, your revision doesn't help you if you do not keep doing it regularly, and you tend to waste time in revising and, you know, putting in more efforts to memorize them again and then revise them. So do have a track of your memory cycle and do keep revising according to your particular need. One essential point is a comprehensive book on general knowledge. Yes, dear friends, you need to read one particular book on general knowledge thoroughly and religiously. You need to read it regularly, you need to revise it repeatedly. You can either choose a book by Arihant or Lucent, both of them are good. It's up to you whichever book you want to choose, because reading this particular book will provide you at one particular place all minor informations regarding India and the world. The national parks in India, the biosphere parks in India, the rivers in India, east flowing rivers in India, west flowing rivers in India, the peninsular rivers in India, Himalayan rivers in India, tributaries of Godavari, tributaries of Krishna, you know, the thermal power plants in India, hydropower projects in India. These are very, very basic and very, very essential elements for the prelims level of the examination of APSC or any other competitive examination in India. So you need to have a very good and very strong hold upon one of the comprehensive books of general studies. Then you need to read the India Yearbook. By India Yearbook, we must mention that you do not need to read a book by XYZ publisher or XYZ author. By India Yearbook, what we mean is the India Yearbook published by the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India. Then, very important thing about preparation of APSC prelims is that you need to put greater relevance of your preparation in the Assam part of the syllabus. Yes, dear friends, it doesn't matter much how much you know about what's happening in Argentina or what's happening in Russia or what's happening in Surat, unless you have a very good hold about what's happening in Assam, the very basics about Assam, the number of districts in Assam, the size of the districts, the year in which each district came up, you know, the forests of Assam, the animals of Assam, the natural resources of Assam. If you do not have a good knowledge about the rivers and the river systems of Assam, their tributaries, it doesn't make much difference. If you might know, you know, things about the entire globe, entire world, but you will get questions that are asked from your particular state in APSC prelims. So you need to know the basic facts about Assam. So do put good amount of stress and good amount of relevance on, you know, making notes about these things about Assam. Let's now look into a topic-wise list of books for APSC prelims general studies. We will begin with Indian Polity. So for Indian Polity, you need to read two NCERT books essentially. NCERT Class 8, Social and Political Life, Part 3, and NCERT Class 11, Indian Constitution at Work. Dear friends, you need to do a very fast reading of these two NCERT books. You cannot afford to spend entire year reading NCERT books. You need to complete these books, two books, either by at the max 2 weeks, you know, 1.5 weeks or 2 weeks you should take to complete these two books. And then you should go to this third book called Indian Polity for Civil Services Examinations by M. Lakshmikant. Make sure that you have the latest edition of the book by Lakshmikant. At present, I guess the latest edition is the fifth edition. So in case you do not have the fifth edition, go to a bookstore and find out the changes that have been made from the 4th or the 3rd edition which you have at your home, and either have a photocopy of this particular part which is not available in your book, or try to, you know, download it or find it from any other place and compile it. Then the India Yearbook, we have already mentioned, the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. Do read that book regularly. That book has a part on Indian Polity which will be relevant for Indian Polity. Then there is one book published by Pratiyogita Darpan. They come up with a series called General Studies, in which Indian Polity and Governance is a book which they publish under this particular series of General Studies. You can read this book, you can buy this book, and you can read this book. Once you are done with the above three books, the first three books, that is the NCERTs and the Indian Polity by Lakshmikant. And believe me, Lakshmikant is the Bible for preparation of Indian Polity. Once you are done, once you have a thorough hold over Lakshmikant, you can more or less solve any question on Indian Polity. So after you have a hold over Lakshmikant and the NCERT books, then you can buy this book by Pratiyogita Darpan, because this is a very good book for revision. It provides information in bullets and pointers, and it also contains several multiple choice questions for your practice. And trust me, the golden rule for scoring good in Indian Polity part is, you know, solving as many MCQs as possible, because you never know how many kinds of questions can be asked from one particular article of Indian Constitution. So it's better to practice as many MCQs as possible, and trust me, this is the most successful tip about scoring well in Indian Polity. Next, let's look into political system in India. For political system in India, you can go through the NCERT book of Class 7, which is called Social and Political Life Part 2, NCERT Class 8, Social and Political Life Part 3, NCERT Class 10, Democratic Politics Part 2. So if you read the NCERT Class 8 book, you find that there is similarities for two topics of the syllabus. You know, first topic, Indian Polity, is also covered, and this particular topic is also covered. So please keep in mind to essentially go through the NCERTs, because they are the very basic books. And second thing is that do not put the entire year in reading NCERT books. Do read NCERT books first, do come back to them, and do revise them very frequently. Then there's this book called Governance in India for Civil Services Examination by M. Lakshmikant again. This also is a very good book. You can follow this book for preparation of political system in India. And if time permits, you can go through this last book, you know, this not last book, say one another book called Indian Political System, A Critical Study of the Constitutional Structure and the Emerging Trends of Indian Politics by J.C. Johari. This is a very informative book, but it will take you some time to complete this book. So read this book if and only if, you know, you are done with the above mentioned books and you have some extra time with you now. So now let's look into the current events of national and international importance part of the syllabus. For this, the thumb rule is newspapers, of course. So one national and one regional newspaper. We have already made a lecture on how to read newspapers and what to read in newspapers. You can find the link to that particular video in the description box of this particular video. Go and watch that video. We hope that will be helpful in guiding you to how to read newspapers and what to read in newspaper. Then there is internet, of course. Go to Google each evening, put some half an hour to 45 minutes to find out what's happening in the world, what's happening in the country. Then try to make notes of all those happenings that is going on around the world. And most important thing about current events of national and international importance is that you need to be able to, you know, find some synergy of that things, of the current happenings, with the static part of the syllabus. Say for instance, you need to be able to establish a link between what has happened in the budget session of the parliament with what you have read in the Lakshmikant from the parliament section of the book Lakshmikant. And then let's look into Indian economy. For Indian economy, you can read NCERT class 10, Understanding Economic Development, and NCERT class 11, Indian Economic Development. Do read these two books very fast and do come back to them repeatedly and do revise them very frequently. Then there is this book called Indian Economy by Ramesh Singh. This is also a very good book, it goes without saying. It provides you, you know, with the basic understanding of the very basic concepts and basic terms of economy. You can read this book if you have some time. Then the book by Pratyogita Darpan, you know, the same series on general studies which I had talked about for Indian polity, also comes for Indian economy. You can buy this book. This will help you in revision, and this will also provide you with lots of MCQs which will you know, strengthen your confidence and which will, you know, boost up your confidence in this particular topic. Then you need to also read the, you know, the newspapers, the economy part of the newspapers. You should keep a track of it, what's happening around, you know. And then you can go to YouTube lectures. Of course, you can follow, you should subscribe to Social Sciences Junction if you haven't done it already, because we assure you that we will come up with lectures for each particular topic and each particular item of the syllabus of the APSC in coming times. So let's now look into the next topic called planning process in India. For planning process in India, you can go through NCERT class 12, Politics in India since independence, and NCERT class 11, Indian Economic Development. Then above and beyond reading these two books, you should have a very good hold over the all the 5-year plans of India till date. So for that, you can do Google search of each individual 5-year plan. Say you go and type in Google first 5-year plan, and you get a whole lot of information about the first 5-year plan. You need to trace out what were the targets of the particular 5-year plan, what were the achievements of that plan at the end of it, what were the failures, and how did the subsequent 5-year plan took up to, you know, rectify the failures of the previous 5-year plan. These are the very, very essential things which you need to know thoroughly. So make a note of all the 5-year plans. If time permits, you should read this book, India Since Independence. It is a very, very interesting book and very, very informative book by Bipin Chandra, Midula Mukherjee and Aditya Mukherjee. Then there is this book called India Unbound by Gurucharan Das. I suggest this book because the manner in which this particular book has been written will provide you a break from the monotony of the day in and day out reading of NCERT books and all those informative books by Lakshmikant and other writers. So this book will provide you with knowledge and information about India, you know, planning process in India. At the same time, it will help you to break the monotony of the regular textbooks. In the upcoming videos, as we have already mentioned, we can assure you that we will come up with videos, we'll come up with lectures for each particular topic of the syllabus mentioned by APSC, such as the geography of Assam and world, the role of science and technology, history of India and Assam, Indian national movement with special reference to Assam, general mental ability, and so on and so forth. Please take our word, we will definitely come up with lectures for each particular topic of the syllabus provided by APSC. But for this video, thank you so much for viewing it. Please like this video and share it with your friends. Also, kindly subscribe to our channel if you haven't done it already. Do turn on the notification icon so that you do not miss any of our updates. Thank you once again. Hope to see you in the next lecture.